Welcome to another i2R Tech Lighting Solutions tutorial video. The Moving Head Controller 2.0 can be set up under a few different modalities. Modalities are functional behaviors, and each one of the six available light groups can be set up as one of these modalities in a mixed configuration fashion. The three modalities we speak of are sliders mode, pan and tilt mode, and follow spot mode. They were already introduced and described in the sliders mode tutorial, so make sure to watch that one before you continue here. In this video, we explain the pan and tilt modality, and it is assumed that at this point, the right libraries were created and assigned to the corresponding light groups, as it was explained in the library management and light parameters management tutorial videos. To activate the pan and tilt modality for the moving head, the lower button of the corresponding light group must be active or blinking, but the top button must remain off. In this mode, the joystick and sliders will only control the moving head linked to the active light group. Choose the active light, one light at a time. The joystick will directly control the pan and tilt angles for the light. That is, if the joystick is pushed to the right, the pan angle rotation will increase in value. If pushed to the left, the pan angle rotation will decrease. If the light is placed on a flat surface, the pan motion will appear to follow the joystick motion. But if the light is hanging upside down, then the pan motion will appear to go in reverse. The same goes for the tilt angle. The apparent movement changes with the light placement and the tilt angle. So just remember that if the light moves when the joystick is pushed, then everything is working as expected. The easiest thing to do in pan and tilt mode is to aim a white beam or spot to a wall, the floor, or some static object. In pan and tilt mode, you could aim more than one light at the same target, or you could aim more than one light to different targets, but you would have to aim each light independently, one light at a time. Once you aim one of the lights at a desired target, or wall, or the floor, you can then apply any of the light's built-in effects using the sliders. Effects like color, gobo, zoom, prism, etc. Some lights, such as the i2R BSW200, allows for a custom-made gobo placement. This is good for applications where a logo or a monogram has to be projected over a wall, a screen, the floor, or even the ceiling. In addition to light spotting and monogram projection, the pan and tilt modality is good for creating chases and custom light shows. But that is a subject for another video. Thank you for watching this tutorial, and don't forget to watch the entire series to get a good grasp of all the potential and different possibilities for the moving head controller 2.0.